The man in charge of President Trump's budget, Mick Mulvaney, he joins us right now. Mr. Mulvaney, thank you for joining us this morning. You're already getting a lot of reaction to those plans we saw yesterday. Big increase in defense spending, cuts in domestic programs. Democrats say that's going to just take a wrecking ball to programs that help the middle class, like clean water, food safety, education. And even Republican budget experts believe the cuts like this are going to be dead on arrival on Capitol Hill. So is this all symbolism?
No, it's the president doing exactly what he said he would do when he ran. The budget is nothing more than the manifestation through expenditures of policy. And what you see in this budget is exactly what the president ran on. He ran on increasing spending on the military. He ran on defending the border. He ran on enforcing the laws that are already on the books. He ran on giving things like school choice more opportunity. And that's what's reflected in the budget.
As you know, sir, the president also said he was going to pay down the debt, start to balance the budget. This doesn't bring down deficits at all, your plan, and you've said, you yourself have said many times that can't happen unless you take on Medicare, unless you take on Social Security, and the president says he's not going to do that.
Sure, George, and as you know, when you were here, this is a budget blueprint. The first year of a new administration, the budget process is a little different. We're actually rolling out the budget blueprint a little bit earlier than we otherwise would, in large part because of the delay the Senate Democrats had in getting me confirmed. So we're letting the public know earlier than ordinary. And where we are now is simply the top line discretionary spending. It won't be until May till we reveal our first thoughts on the big ideas like tax policy, healthcare reform, in terms of how that translates into the dollars and cents. Infrastructure will be after that. So
let me just stop you right there. Can the president keep his promise both to move the budgets towards balance, pay down the debt, and not touch Medicare and Social Security?
Well, which is, again, those are bigger discussions for another day. But look at what he's done here. He's kept his promises without adding to this year's deficit. It would have been very easy for the president to come in and say, let's spend more money and let's blow up the deficit. But what you're seeing here is a very powerful message to your earlier point. What the president wants is to move spending from, say, overseas back in this country. That's why you'll see fairly significant reductions in his proposals regarding foreign aid. But he's doing all of this without adding to this year's deficit. And I think that is a very powerful message from the president of the United States to Congress.
The president promising something special tonight on health care. But it looks like his plans to repeal and replace Obamacare are kind of stuck on Capitol Hill right now. So is the president going to come forward tonight with a specific plan of his own? And will it meet his promise to cover everyone at lower costs?
Tonight, I don't want to give away what the president's going to say tonight. That's not my job. But what I think you've seen already is work done by Tom Price, the new head of Health and Human Services, also, by the way, late in getting appointed. You're starting to see some of the impacts, George, of the obstruction with the cabinet. What you'll see tonight is an introduction to some of the topics. I don't think you'll see specifics for the next couple of weeks.
But is the president standing by his promise not to sign a replacement bill that will cause people to lose coverage?
Look at it this way. The president has done nothing but keep his promises up to now. Again, the budget is a manifestation of that. He promised this, this, and this, and the budget has it. He promised to reduce that, that, and that, and the budget delivers that. So if the president has done anything in his first month in office, he has proved that he is, in fact, keeping his promises, and I think you could expect that to continue.
But you would agree that until you get to the big-ticket promises on tax cuts, on balancing the budget, on health care, what you're talking about now is a small fraction of what it's going to take.
Well, certainly the big issues of the day are the things that you just mentioned, and it's going to take more than I've been on the job, I think, 9 days, more than 9 days to start to address those things. And I do hope we get a chance to address them. We just haven't had a chance to do it in this first couple of weeks, and that's not the purpose of the budget that we brought forth last night.
Mr. Mulvaney, thanks very much for your time this morning.
Thanks, George.